Let's talk about nomination and consent.
It doesn't matter, actually. Kenyans are very clear, as you can see.
Let's talk about nominations and consensus. And Honorable Constantine, I'll start with you on this one. Is this the way to go, and where does the will of space for the will of the people start? Because we've seen this also on your side, Halwale giving space for Malala, we saw Soipan Tuya and Tongoyo giving space for Lentutu, but where is the space for people's choice?
Well, Trevor, you know, there are areas whereby you need to reduce political competition within your team so that to enhance your likelihood of success, depending on the opposition that you face. And I think Narok was one of the areas where we had three very strong and able gubernatorial candidates in the name of Soipan, Tongoya, and Lentutu. And Kakamega, we had Bonnie Halwale and Cleopas Malala, who were both running on different outfits earlier. And then with the Kenya Kwanza Alliance coming in, then they ended up being in one team. And I really have respect for anybody who can give in to a consensus arrangement like that has happened. Because that is another way of doing nominations. It's allowed, it's legal, and it is acceptable within the players, or rather the participants of the whole event. So I think it's a way to go. It's a good thing. It happens when the party is popular, when the party has a lot of following. That is what happens. Unfortunately, in this situation, you'll never see Jubilee in this situation, because Jubilee has been struggling to get aspirants. Yet to know exactly how many aspirants Jubilee has within the entire republic. In UDA, I think we have 5,000, close to 5,800 aspirants. At some stages, we have about 20 aspirants going for the same seats. And they all know that you only require one person. So I think going forward, it's a good thing that if we can build consensus, it is acceptable. And when there is no consensus, then we do free and fair nominations like we did in Jubilee and we're going to do in the UDA.
Okay. Priscilla, you're the one who was very passionate about this conversation.
Sure.
Where is the space for the people's voice now?
That's true. Where is the space for the people's voice? But also, where is the sort of space that allows the parliament to be the face of Kenya? So it's actually two things, and all of these are covered in our constitution, because special interest groups of women, young persons, and persons with disability are supposed to come on board. I have been quite happy with most of the parties in the sense that the women are paying 50% of the nomination fees, and in some parties like Jubilee, persons with disability are not paying anything for their nomination fees. But then it must be in a way that there is consultation, access to information, regard for the time that people have put in the campaigns, and all of these methods of getting candidates are then agreed upon by party members. So that is true that the first level of getting candidates from the party primaries must be consensus building. I, for example, like that our governors have term limits. So if a governor has a term limit of 2 terms, it then means that in not very long, that position will be available. So instead of having so many candidates fight for one position which will be available, you know, and this is not the last election. So it's true there has to be consensus building. Then there has to be free and fair nominations. And when you go for free and fair nominations, you really must just do exactly that. I have favored myself a position where IEBC assists parties in the free and fair nominations. But even other than IEBC, there can be other, maybe corporate bodies, maybe individuals who don't have as much direct interest in the party nominations outcome as the politicians do. So parties have got to think through this method of free and fair nominations, and we are particularly worried ourselves that if there are no free and fair nominations, many women candidates will then not be able to come on to the elections in August. If there's consensus building, it must be consensus building that does not knock out all the special interest group candidates who sometimes don't have a big name, they don't have a lot of money, they don't have a huge track record. So there must be some affirmative action, essentially, as we go into this election. And we're looking at the big parties to see how they resolve these questions. Yeah. The UDA, it's true, has a lot of candidates. The Jubilee, and I want to tell Caleb not to worry, we have enough candidates. And we also have enough processes and procedures. Usijali, hakuna haja ya kuchungulia nyumba ya jirani, kila mtu sasa ashughulikie nyumba yake, since everybody has a bit of a crisis with this matter.
Yeah.
So UDA, Jubilee, and even ODM, that we give the country the best leaders possible.
Yeah.
I don't favor a situation in which we give the country weak leaders, because if we continue giving the country weak leaders, process through the nominations, we are not achieving our development goals. So in this election, because this is a transition election from the fourth president to the fifth president, let the president be supported by a team of very strong leaders, very strong senators, very strong governors and very strong members of parliament who are the face of Kenya, men and women who are good leaders of our country. And so that when you come to the election, you then have a competition of good leaders and good ideas. If people choose the UDA candidate, if people choose the Jubilee candidate, they are assured of getting the best representation in the Houses of Parliament. It will take a lot of consensus building at the table. And even when they come to the coalition, again, the coalition is not a place for sacrificing candidates. The coalition must be a place where we then get the best arrangement. Governor, deputy governor, senator, women rep, again, the regional diversity within a county has got to be addressed. It's an interesting season. This month of April is really the month of nominations. And we are hoping all the parties put their best foot forward in that process.
This really is it. And Bondai, where do you draw the line? Because when you get to consensus, that is not the voice of the people. There are many other interests that go in there. What if you choose for them someone they really did not want, but party has just decided that because you put us together and we agreed that this is the person you're giving, but it's not necessarily the best leader, and it's not necessarily the person the people actually want?
You know, Trevor, ours is a fledgling multi-party democracy. And the world over, when political parties put forth candidates or nominate candidates to fly their flags in elections, they look at two considerations. One is the ability of that candidate to win the election, in other words, popularity. No party would ever want to front a weakling or an unpopular candidate to face an election against opponents from other parties. Two is how that person connects with the party, ideologically speaking, that is able, once elected, to articulate the ideals, the policies of the party in whatever house he goes to, be it county assembly, national assembly, or senate, in our case. So those are two considerations.
Yeah.
But then there has been this clamor for people, the universal suffrage, that people need to, that people's voice need to be heard, which is true and correct and proper. But then our political parties, as currently constituted in this country, lack the capacity, lack the infrastructure to conduct credible, fair, and open nominations that involve the public. And therefore, many a times you have to strike a balance, delicate balance. Okay. On the other hand, you don't want to disfranchise your members in terms of determining who becomes the flag bearer of the party. On the other hand, you want also to be realistic and make a decision based on certain realities. And that's where consensus comes in. Consensus is important in the sense that it reduces the heat. It reduces the possible commotion, the possible fallout from these nominations. And you have said before, and now and again, that where consensus fails, then we give the people a chance. And the people here basically refers to party members, which is now called the law under the Act, Political Parties Act that was amended recently. And you must also understand that most of these political parties have got a provision in their constitutions and their party nomination rules and guidelines that gives the parties the latitude to give out direct tickets to persons whom they perceive as being able to fly their flags and win the elections and articulate their affairs in their houses.
Yeah.
And that's what we've seen happening here and there. Mm. Here and there. So there's nothing wrong, really, with all these methods.
Okay.
The most important thing is the end result. This is basically a means to an end.
Yeah.
But we must be very clear as we do this that we don't end up subverting democracy.
The will of the people.
Okay. Yes, yes.
All right. Kagusha, let me bring you in on this because you're all going to face this and most likely this month that we're heading into April. What is the best way of dealing with it?
Well, as far as I'm concerned, the best way of dealing with the issue of party primaries is just to do a credible party primary process. And the reason why the government, or rather parliament, passed a law that would provide resources to political parties from the exchequer, from the taxpayer, was so that the political parties would be able to organize themselves in such a way that they're able to deliver democracy in the country. For example, I don't really understand why, especially the major political parties that have been benefiting from the political parties fund, why they shouldn't be able to organize well-structured, well-organized, and well-capacitated structure to conduct party primaries. As we talk today, political parties are probably receiving so much money, just as what IEBC would be getting for that component, yeah. You know, for that component. And so that means political parties need to organize themselves in such a way that they're able to deliver democracy through proper and well-orderly party primaries that would take care of all the interests in the counties, in the national elections, and be able to afford every person a fair chance to compete. And I like the way Honorable Nyokabi puts it, especially about the people with disability and the women, which really is her pet subject, and she does very well on that. It would be very important that we afford women that opportunity. And you know why this is important? It helps us to deal with the issues of third gender rule.
Yeah.
So that, again, when we're in parliament, we don't again have to deal with the deficiencies that we have suffered in the last couple of elections. And so I would say that would be the best way to handle this.
Okay.
Having said that, is incumbent upon political parties also to look at the candidates that they have. And within the political party arrangement and structures, if they know that clearly they have people who are quite popular in their areas,
yeah.
And you know someone is popular, when you ask the issue of the face of the people, where is the face of the people, where is the will of the people? If someone kind of has so much support from all the other people,
yeah.
And the way and like now we are having very unique circumstances in this election, and I think that's why major political parties are actually avoiding the party primaries case. You see, you have two contestants in your political party. Let's say, like in UDA, you have two contestants, like probably the way we had with the gubernatorial race in Nyeri.
Yeah.
You have two candidates who are within the political party. But one is more popular than the other to a great extent. And now you, on the other side, you have the opponents from the other political party. They probably have one candidate. Now it means you're going to fight it out in your political party, then go and face the person from the opposite side. You are likely to consume a lot of your resources and a lot of your energy at this point when you're doing the party primaries. And then you become worn out. And then you go face your main political opponent in August this year. So without having that in mind, most of the political parties are saving their last sweat for the last days and for the main opponents,
yeah.
You know, are the main ballot in okay. August this year. So political parties are just trying to be, you know, efficient in terms of how they are going to deliver their candidates in 2018. I mean, in August,
yeah.
This 2022 election.
Okay.
Yeah. So and that is allowed by law.
Okay.
That is allowed by law. But then it must be done in a way that it doesn't subvert democracy.
Okay.
It doesn't in any way,
yeah.
make any candidate feel like they have been offended. And yeah. that is where we are talking of consensus. When you're talking of consensus, we are talking of two people agreeing.
Okay.
That I agree. That you have reached here, I agree. Yes, I have tried this far, but I have not probably reached where you are.
Yeah.
So let us agree that we can have certain concessions with these reasons and the way forward.
All right.
Yeah.
I want us to talk on the last topic, which is the Uhuru's last budget. It's on the front page of the Standard. Raila and Ruto eyeing share. They will come to that in just a bit. But Honorable Kositany, as we wind up on these conversations on nomination and consensus, do you foresee a fallout going forward?
Well, elections are very is a very slippery, especially when it's when you hear people claiming that one person interfered with an entire nomination process of Jubilee to bring in candidates of his choice. I've met very few politicians who claim to have lost fairly, but I think in UDA we're going to do a fair, free and fair nomination. whoever loses will have lost because and must respect the will of the people. So I think the fallouts will be there. And I think now with the new political parties law, they will only be able to run as independents. But if you lose in a free and fair nomination, it does not matter whether you defect or rather go and run independently, you will still lose because the voters will still be the same. But I hope that with the kind of competition that we have, the kind of awareness that we have now, is we're going to conduct a free and fair nominations, and everybody is going to be, the will of the people is going to be reflected in the results of the people that they will nominate. And I speak for the UDA party, not for any other political affiliation.
Okay. Priscilla.
Yeah, just one. The only thing for us in Jubilee is we know that premium tiers are loading in UDA. Watu watalia kule. Nominations ikiisha. But that is for them. That is for them. Vile tulilia, watalia vile tulilia. But that is for them. So now, the point I wanted to bring across is the dispute resolution.
Yeah.
And I think that Caleb speaks well about fallouts. You know, it's only one position, it's only one ticket. But there must be some dispute resolution mechanisms across all the parties so that we're also strengthening the legal mechanisms of processing disputes within the parties. So I'm hoping that all the parties have put together very strong independent dispute resolution mechanism so that if you feel aggrieved by the consensus building or even by the party primaries, that you then are able to resolve that dispute in time for the for the election.
But
and
that
if there's any fallout, if you suspect that you're going to be falling out, you don't need to fall out. You run to another party, and the Jubilee doors are open.
But this
although the time, I think the time ran.
It has lapsed.
But the time has lapsed. So, so now it is.
The people have to work in their parties. And I must say, Trevor.
You and God.
I must say, Trevor. The Jubilee Party really worked overdrive last week to try and recruit candidates. I know, like in my constituency, we did not. We only had Jubilee candidates in one of the wards. Yeah. In the other three wards, we did not have. I remember I met one of the ladies who had been recruited to one of the Jubilee political parties. I mean, as a member aspirant in MCA. And I asked her, are you sure you went to Jubilee? And she was, Speaker, what do you think? Should I quit? And I told her, the decision is yours. But I also talked to one gentleman from my ward.
Yeah.
And when we were talking, he was actually shaking. And I asked him, so why did you have to join? He told me he was promised, I don't know. Then I told him, then you have to decide what you want. Anyway, by evening, he had already quit and he went back to UDA because he had already paid, for the ticket. So we have a very interesting scenario where the Jubilee Party was trying to, but now you see that door has closed. It was closed on Saturday at midnight. And so now whoever were recruited have now to work within that arrangement. Whoever is now in UDA have to work within that arrangement. But again, I would want to say that in UDA party, those people who are going to be contesting, and there are many of them, of course, well, we are going to have very, very fair party primaries.
Okay.
And we are going to be opening all the streams, all the polling stations and polling centers, so that we have no struggle in terms of numbers of people who are coming and how first they are cleared.
Yeah.
We are going to ensure that they are going even to be observers, both media and international observers. This, our party primaries, is very, very organized, is very serious. And I dare say, the most organized political party today, of course, is also the most popular political party today in Kenya. It is the UDA party. It is organized, and you could clearly see this when...
Don't say that until the test comes. Wait for the nomination.
We can look at the way we have been conducting our business. I remember, even when we had this issue of resignation of civil servants and public servants and so forth and so on.
Yeah.
I saw, and I've seen the Veronica Maina actually leading the way to have a lot of organized meetings with IEBC and the ORPP, the Office of the Register of Political Parties. And she has really tried her very best to bring a semblance of discussions that are leading into agreement and arrangements on how political parties should be able to conduct themselves.
Okay.
Even with the newly amended laws that have affected affected some of the political parties so largely and so impactfully,
yes,
and they were pushing for the amendments. I mean, the UDA party has again led a kind of an arrangement where political parties agree and the ORPP office also agrees on, yeah, what should be done and what should not be done. So that, again, political parties do not get themselves into a lot of trouble.
Okay.
Yeah, for example,
referring to UDA, not even Kenya Kwanza. I mean, the coalition doesn't matter.
It's, I mean, the coalition is developing. It has started recently. It has come up recently. But the organization that has been there and very organized and well structured has been the UDA party. And Kenya Kwanza now has come and they have to kind of now benefit from the organization and arrangement that the UDA party has actually been having. But as now we are moving forward, definitely they are part of the coalition.
So they're just piggybacking on UDA?
No, they have their own arrangements. They have their own arrangements. But of course, you know, Kenya Kwanza is having political parties that are not necessarily national political parties that are across the whole region, I mean the whole country. But UDA party, of course, the UDA party, you know, is a national political party that has its wings across the whole country. I mean, when you talk of ANC, when you talk of DAP, I don't know, is it a DAP or, DAP, you sometimes would imagine is a fertilizer. But when you talk of those political parties, they may not necessarily be, you know, across, you know, across the country. And like maybe a political party like UDA and maybe ODM and Jubilee, which, you know, stride across the region, I mean the regions.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, on the OPO, before
you know, Trevor.
Change topics.
Because I would give them the benefit of doubt and wish them well. But you see, both UDA and my friend Speaker Kagosia have got no experience with nominations. It's the first time they'll be attempting to carry out nominations. UDA as a party and him as a candidate. So
we'll set the standards.
The taste of the pudding will be in the 80.
Yeah. We'll set the standards.
As ODM, Trevor, you know, we are an established political movement with wide acclaim, not only in Kenya but across the region. So we are set, and our members need to be assured that we shall be conducting credible nominations across the board, from MCA position to the position of governor, okay? And everyone who has applied to be a candidate will be given a fair chance to compete with the rest of the persons who are also vying.
Yeah.
And we all expect that at the end of the day, we shall have the most credible and most popular candidates across the board,
okay,
to be able to win these elections. Yes, hands down. Alongside our partners in the Azimio la Umoja movement,
okay,
yes, who are also doing very, very well.
Yeah,
Jubilee is doing well. Wiper is doing very well. DAP Kenya is doing extremely well, and many, many others. Yes.
Okay. You wanted to wind up on this before you switch topics.
I think at the end of this is really good leadership. So, I mean, sympathy, for example, to a party like UDA that hasn't done nominations, and also sympathy to ODM that has done nominations and even Jubilee. So to just hope that these nominations are done in a way that the crop of leaders that we produce in this election is really the best for the country. And I think we wish all our parties, and we wish ourselves also, because we are all candidates also for the nomination.
Yeah.
And I love that all the parties are promising free and fair nominations.
Okay.
Can we see free and fair nominations? Although a bit worried that UDA already has a list of those with direct tickets. So I don't know how free and fair, some have direct. But anyway, yote tisa.
You know, Priscilla, as you
let the nominations be free and fair.
Yeah.
Let's have the best candidates going on to the August election.
Priscilla, as we wish as well, in these nominations, I just want to also inform you that personally, I'm facing no contest in nomination.
So you already have a direct...
I'm
already has a direct
candidate.
you know.